In the annals of medical history, there exist peculiar remedies, and one such curiosity from the medieval times was the enigmatic mummy powder. Imagine, if you will, the mystique of Egypt's ancient sands and the journey of mummies through time as they transcended from the sacred realms of the pharaohs to the curio cabinets of medieval Europe. These well-preserved remains found themselves ground into a fine powder, believed to hold the power to heal and cure. Welcome to our journey through the peculiar world of mummy powder, a substance that once captivated the imagination of healers and alchemists. In this exploration, we will uncover the origins, the beliefs, and the remarkable tales surrounding the use of ground-up mummy remains, particularly from Egypt, as a remedy for various illnesses. Step with us into the past, where history, science, and a touch of the bizarre converge to reveal the secrets of mummy powder and its place in the ever-evolving story of human health. The origins of mummy powder, our enigmatic topic today, can be traced back to the illustrious civilization that thrived along the Nile. The ancient Egyptians believed in life beyond death, a journey that required a preserved body. As we gaze upon the hieroglyphics adorning the tombs and the intricate paintings depicting life in the afterworld, we begin to understand the significance of mummification. To the Egyptians, it was not a macabre practice but a sacred ritual. The process of mummification was meticulous, an art form that preserved the body for eternity. It involved carefully removing the internal organs, dehydrating the corpse, and wrapping it in linen bandages. The result? Mummies that defied time itself, with faces that seemed to gaze into eternity. These were the vessels for the souls of the departed, journeying through the afterlife. Fast forward to medieval Europe, where a new chapter in the story of mummy powder begins. European explorers and adventurers were drawn to the mysteries of Egypt. Their quests often led to the unwrapping of mummies. It was during these explorations that the remnants of these ancient Egyptian lives made their way to Europe, particularly during the Renaissance. The demand for these relics was driven by a mix of curiosity and a quest for rare and exotic materials. The mummies were carefully collected, packaged, and sent back to Europe, where they found a surprisingly receptive audience. Medieval European markets were a hub of activity, where merchants traded in spices, silks, and other exotic goods. Mummies, in various forms, joined this eclectic mix. They were prized not only for their novelty but for the belief that they contained mystical properties. Mummies were often displayed in curio cabinets or apothecaries, where they piqued the curiosity of the educated elite. Their presence in these cabinets symbolized an intellectual fascination with the ancient world and a desire to possess a piece of it. Those who possessed mummy powder believed it to contain the essence of ancient Egyptian knowledge, passed down through the ages. Some considered it a gateway to the secrets of the pharaohs and the mystical arts. Alchemists, in particular, held mummy powder in high regard. They believed it had transformative properties, capable of transmuting base metals into precious gold. To them, it was a mystical substance that embodied the secrets of the universe. Medieval manuscripts are filled with references to mummy powder and its supposed powers. These writings describe rituals and practices in which the powder played a central role, from concocting elixirs of longevity to invoking spiritual insights. Alchemists and apothecaries would spend hours in their dimly lit laboratories, experimenting with the powder. They believed that mummy powder was the key to unlocking the secrets of life and the universe itself. Visiting a medieval doctor's office might have involved a prescription that included a dose of mummy powder. It was administered in various forms, from powders to tinctures, with the expectation of alleviating the patient's suffering. This mystical powder was prescribed for a variety of conditions, from stomach ailments to epilepsy. Some believed it could even ward off curses and protect against supernatural forces. To the alchemists of the time, mummy powder was not just a substance. It was a symbol of hidden knowledge and the quest for transformation. The goal was not merely to create elixirs and remedies, but to unlock the deepest mysteries of the universe. Within the hushed sanctuaries of alchemical practice, mummy powder was carefully mixed with other exotic substances. The alchemists believed this mysterious powder could catalyze the fusion of elements, leading to the creation of the fabled philosopher's stone. In the light of modern scientific investigation, the composition of mummy powder has been demystified. Scientific analysis of mummy powder has revealed its true nature. It is primarily composed of the minerals and substances used in the mummification process. The ancient rituals preserved the body, but the mystical qualities ascribed to the powder were unfounded. The contrast between the beliefs of the medieval era and our current understanding is stark. What was once considered a remedy for various ailments is now viewed as a cultural relic of a bygone time. Our journey through the captivating world of mummy powder comes to an end, but the story of this mystical substance and its place in history will forever linger in the corridors of human curiosity. We hope you've enjoyed this exploration of mummy powder. As we continue on our quest to understand the mysteries of health, we invite you to join us in future adventures. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more captivating journeys into the world of health, history, and science. Until our next adventure, stay curious and stay healthy.